Good morning, everybody. Today's topic of discussion is OFDMA. On the same topic, I earlier uploaded an video, but due to some technical issue, audio was not there. I am extremely sorry for that. So this video again, I am shooting with audio. So here it goes. The contents are like this. First of all, we will look into the introduction part, how OFDMA works. Then overly, how does OFDM differs from OFDMA? So basically, if you look into things, day by day, number of Wi-Fi users are increasing. You can say it increases drastically. Okay. To meet this particular challenge of high density deployments of Wi-Fi devices, IEEE came with a new standard called 802.11ax. So as per the new, we call it as Wi-Fi 6 as well. So this is completely backward compatible with the previous generations of Wi-Fi, that is A, B, G, N, AC, etc. So the main motive of this standard is for faster network performance and to connect more devices simultaneously. Here we are expecting 4x capacity increase over the previous standard, that is 802.11ac. So what we are trying to say here is this transitioning of Wi-Fi from a best effort endeavor to a deterministic wireless technology. .11ax access points deployed in dense device environments, so which will support all the users concurrently connected with more diverse usage profiles. So this made possible by a range of technologies which can optimize the spectral efficiency, increase the throughput, and reduce power consumption. So the underlying technologies here are OFDMA, that is orthogonal frequency division multiple access. The second one is TWT, that is target wake time, then BSS coloring, 1024 QAM, and the last one is MU-MIMO. So in this topic, we are going to discuss in detail about OFDMA and how it increase the 4x network performance. If you look at the current and the older Wi-Fi standards, those are basically client-centric. So client, you mean station side. So which is basically contention-based approach. Okay. This is very difficult to be maintained for the modern high density deployments. So in order to overcome, they came up with a new technology called OFDMA, which is completely AP-centric. that enables 802.11x access points to simultaneously connect with multiple devices by dividing each of the Wi-Fi channel into smaller subchannels. In short, we call it as RU, that is resource units. So here the access point is going to determine how to allocate the subchannels as each individual RU and how can be utilized for different clients that are serviced simultaneously. See, here I gave some pictorial presentation how OFDMA works. AP has to allocate the whole channel to a single user in a given time frame, or it may partition the whole channel to serve the multiple devices simultaneously. In that way, this technique improves the usability throughput for all the devices connected to an AP. In this OFDMA, if you look at it, allocation and scheduling capability, which is supported by OFDMA, allows multiple devices to receive more consistent attention. This reduces the contention methodology, which was supported in the earlier versions of Wi-Fi standard, and moves Wi-Fi from a contention-based to a schedule-based service, which is possible in 802.11x. So here we can say, earlier it was an unmanaged four-way street intersection. Finally, we got a traffic light. So this helps to stabilize Wi-Fi performance, especially in higher density environments, such as where the crowd is more, where the number of connected devices, users are more, such as stadiums, convention centers, transportation hubs, and auditoriums, etc. This OFDMA is mostly useful when multiple connections transmit limited amounts of data. This allows the protocol to squeeze smaller data packets through multiple subchannels. So here we are given an example. In the earlier standard, what happens? It can only send a particular package to one house at a time. Whereas currently what's happening, the same truck can able to carry multiple packages to multiple houses. So that's what I will show you my earlier slide. Here you can see, the user 0 carries the web page of 3 packets. User 1 is carrying streaming video of 2 packets. User 2 is carrying of social media packets. But they have to go in different time. Currently, what they improved is, anyway, we're going to carry the packets from here to there. So in a same truck, they carried out all the things wherever space is available. So this is the time to see the difference between OFDM versus OFDMA. Those are 802.11 A, G, N, AC. Radios use OFDM technology, that is orthogonal frequency division multiplexing, which is useful for single user transmissions. But on the reverse side, so 802.11x radios can utilize orthogonal frequency division multiple axis. This is useful for multi-user version of the OFDMA. You can say in this terms. Both OFDM and OFDMA divided the complete channel into subcarriers through a mathematical function that is called IFFT, inverse fast Fourier transform. The spacing of the subcarriers is orthogonal, so they will not interfere with one another despite the lack of guard bands between them. So this creates signal nulls in the adjacent subcarrier frequencies, thus this preventing intercarrier interference. I hope you can understand here, not an issue. So here if you look at the subcarrier parts, I took an example of 20 MHz 802.11n, yeah, AC channel, whatever you can say here. Here this consists of 64 subcarriers for this 20 MHz channel, of which is 52 data carriers, 4 pilot subcarriers, and 8 unused subcarriers, so which will serve as guard bands also. So sometimes we are referring this as OFDM tones as well. Each OFDM subcarrier is of 312.5 kilohertz. This 802.11ax, they introduced a longer OFDM symbol time of 12.8 microsecond, which is nothing but 4 times longer than the legacy one. So the legacy symbol time is of 3.2 microsecond. So basically how this calculation is happening, subcarrier spacing is reciprocal to the symbol time. So as a result of longer symbol time, the subcarrier size and spacing decreases from 312 kHz, 312.5 kHz to 78.125 kHz. So in this way they did the calculation. So the new subcarrier spacing allows better equalization and therefore it enhances the channel robustness. So as the subcarrier spacing got reduced to 78.125 kHz in comparison to 312.5 kHz, an OFDMA 20 MHz channel consists of total of 256 subcarriers. So here you can look at this. In the legacy part, spacing was 312.5 kHz, whereas here subcarrier spacing is 78.125 kHz. So here the 64 subcarriers, here you can see all things. Other thing, 256 subcarriers. Just like OFDMA, OFDM, there are 3 types of subcarriers here also, whatever we discussed in the earlier thing: data subcarriers, pilot subcarriers, unused subcarriers. Here, one new thing came into picture. They use the same modulation and coding schemes whatever we used in the AC, and on top of that they added 2 new things, 2 new MCS, that is 10 and 11, because we added 1024 QAM. So the pilot subcarriers do not carry this data things, however they are used for synchronization purposes. So between the receiver and transmitter. So the remaining unused subcarriers are basically used for guard carriers or null subcarriers against the to provide the interference from adjacent channels and subchannels. So the tones which are grouped into smaller subchannels known as resource units. In short, we can call it as RUs. Basically, how this is happening? We are dividing the channel for parallel transmissions of small frames to multiple users so that it can happen simultaneously. The data and pilot subcarriers, so within each resource unit, are both adjacent and contiguous within an OFDMA channel. Thank you so much. Whatever possible from my side, I try to explain. If you have any questions, comments, please do let me know in the comment section. Thank you. Bye-bye.